our Constitution has more extensive protections for free speech than any other liberal democracy. Mm-hmm. And it protects hate speech. It does not protect speech that can be understood as an immediate incitement to violence. But it does protect hate speech, and I myself believe, although I understand that other people believe differently, that protecting people's rights to say abhorrent things is an important part of the protection of our right of free speech. But I understand that our students today, they grew up with instruction against bullying in the public schools. They understand what harassment is. They don't understand why it's not okay for them to say something in a classroom or in a dormitory that someone like Milo can come to campus and say in Zellerbach Auditorium.
I want to push you a little harder, though, on this, because the question is how does protecting Milo Yiannopoulos' right to engage in what I personally actually do think is fairly hateful speech, how does that protect my rights to free speech?
Well, the question is, who's the censor? So if you determine that someone has the right of determining what is hate speech and what is not hate speech, I believe you give a dangerous kind of authority to the government. And so someone that is going to censor Milo's right to engage in what we call hate speech today might call hate speech tomorrow something that is, for example, critical of Roy Moore. Mm-hmm. Or critical of the kind of bigotry that you see in some of our far right groups today.
So the danger is that one person's hate speech might be another person's valid criticism of somebody else. And since it's very hard to make the distinction, therefore we have to say, even when we think that it looks like hate speech to us, we need to allow it to make sure we protect the right of the person who would have a valid criticism that others might think is hate speech.
That's exactly right.